I had a girl. I'm gonna tell this story. I had a girl that I was dating, and then she was like, and I was like, you know, the sex was great in the beginning, and then all of a sudden, I couldn't get no head, right? And I go, but I don't do the, I don't do awkward. So yeah. I go, hey, can't get no head here. You're like, yo, what's up?
What up with that? What's up with that?
What's up with the hat? The head? You got no brain, no throat, no esophagus. Not, I can't get nothing. And she was like, well, you know, I just feel like I'm not really good at it. And I go, well, I'm here to practice. This is what I'm here for. I'm here to help you out.
I'll be the judge of that. If I'm still asking for it, yeah, you're doing a good enough job.
Right. And if not, we'll get there. But so she goes, oh, okay. I go, okay. Well, I said, well, understand. So one of the things we tout over and over is that relationships are really simple. You got to figure out what your non-negotiables are, and then never negotiate them. And the thing is, I just want to be clear. Me being in a relationship where I don't get no head is non-negotiable. Now, some people will go, oh, well, that's, you know, it's just this. And no, I am in charge. I'm not making you in charge of my happiness. If this is something that's, I get to decide whatever, what's negotiable, you get to say you're down or you're not. I go, so understand this. I don't want to have this conversation again. So things were good for a while, and then it started to wean off. I called her. I said, "Listen, we're done. We're done. We're done." Well, why? I feel like we're communicating so much, and we're there. And I go, "Well, then why is my dick not in your mouth?" And she's like, "Why do you have to be so?" I go, "I'm not gonna go through this." I mean, I understand how vulgar it sounds in a sense on the surface level, but it's the same thing with respect. If I want this kind of respect, if you don't want to please me, I don't want you to please me. If this is not what you want to do.
You can want whatever you want in a relationship. The thing is that all these relationships are elective and supplemental and additional and additive anyway. So it's like, you might as well, you can set those terms for whatever it is. I just got done working with, I worked with an intimacy coach for 6 months because in the wake of that relationship, and I have all this to say that I agree with you because in the wake of that relationship, I consistently kept landing myself in just like really shitty situations. And part of the work I did with this coach, I hired her because I was like, you know what? This is an area of my life that I'm not good at.
Meet an instructor. Yeah.
I need a coach. Like, I keep picking the wrong partners. I keep putting up for stuff that I know in my heart I don't want to deal with. I'm not happy. I'm not getting what I want. Right. And one of the exercises we did was building out my ideal. And it was over the course of a couple weeks. And she says, you get to pick your ideal, and your ideal is your ideal, and it does exist. And she goes, and it can range from, I want him to have a good job and a good relationship with his family, to I want a big dick. Like, she goes, it can be whatever.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, and it's like, and you know, you're doing that other person a disservice if you stay in something knowing something's missing. And
yeah, you're unhappy in it. Why stay for both of you?
Yeah.
What does an intimacy coach like cover? Like, how does this come about? This is an interesting concept.
Yeah. So I met her actually at. So I mean, I mean, they all coaches nowadays. I had the worst stigma associated with coaches. Like, I even therapy. Like,
because you coached improv for so many years.
That's
why? She was like, because
you realized how little it takes to be listed as a coach. Oh, you've been doing it 3 weeks longer than the rest of us. You're a coach now.
Oh, honey, yeah. I was like, I go, I know how full of shit you are. I was a coach, so yeah. Yeah. No, but I feel like life coaches and stuff were just like social media influencers who bought a notebook and a pen, you know. Like, that's how I looked at them. But I met her at a domestic violence benefit. Okay. She has a history of abusive relationships just like I did. So I think I already, like, you know,
vibed with her. Yeah.
Yeah. And I think that's the only way it works. It's the same way with therapists too. They have to see you for you. You have to come in that office and they have to be like, I get you. Like, you know, I've been through something similar. I understand. But her whole program is helping young women regain their sense of agency in sex and intimacy and get what it is they want. But through, like, I had to go on a detox. Like, I took 6 months off of, like, sex and relationships and all of this stuff. And, like, I really had these tough calls with her multiple times a week, every week, about, like, what are your top line behaviors, your bottom line behaviors? Let's go through every guy you've ever been involved with that has any sort of significance to you. And I want you to list out what was good, what was bad, where do you, it was like the gauntlet. Like, it was it was, yeah, it was a lot, but part of that was the ideal. And then she goes, you deserve to have absolutely everything that you want. If you want a man who eats pussy, then if you come across a man.
I do.
I do. I was like, I mean, hello. Okay. No.
Who doesn't? Who's like, nah, that ain't up my alley. I want a guy who dry heaves a little bit every time we talk about it.
Yeah, exactly. I want a guy who has no idea where the clitoris is. But
how about a dude just wants to go? He goes down with a clothespin on his nose. I mean, look, it's everybody.
Whatever you're into, you could ask for anything. You can ask the universe for anything you want.
Yeah, yeah. Sure.
Yeah.
It's interesting that, you know. So one of the things that while you were telling that story is just the ability to go, I'm gonna submit myself to the process and just do it. Because the whole thing is, if it doesn't work, whatever the fuck.
Yeah, and that's all this stuff is trial and error, all of it. Yeah.
Young Man School 202. Better hear what I've got to say because you won't get it again.
I'm not an alpha male. I'm not a beta male either. I'm just a better man. Better man. Put your happiness first, because if you don't, they won't.